Hey, Kevin, what are you looking at?
These are welding rods for an arc welder. And I had a question the other day from a new welder. He's just teaching himself how to work, how to weld like me. And he said, well, how do you know which rod to use? Which rod do you go by, you know, if you just want to do like general stuff, if you got something special you want to do? So I thought, let's talk about rod a little bit. So I've got three different kinds of rod here. This one is a 6011. The 60 means 60,000 pounds worth of tensile strength. So 60,000 pounds before that weld breaks. The first one means it's good for all positions. Flat, vertical, overhead. If it was a 6021, that would mean it's good for flat or horizontal. If it was a 3, that would mean it was only good for flat welding. Now, the last number, the second one, that stands for what kind of coating it is. And I'm not going to go into that right now. So that's a 6011. Here's a 6013. What's the difference? The type of coating. That's the only difference. Now, this is a 7018. So instead of a 60,000 pound rod, this is a 70,000 pound rod before the weld breaks. The one, it's still good for flat, verticals, overheads, horizontals. And then this one is marked AC, so it's strictly for AC welding rather than AC-DC or DC welding. So there's lots of different variations out there on how you can use the rod or what rod to use for which type of welding you're doing, for what kind of machine you have. Gets confusing after a while. That's why they have books on it. So let's just go ahead and fire up the welder. I'll run them all on the same setting on this little Lincoln buzz box over here. So you can see the difference between the rods, just in how it welds. Same piece of metal, same settings. The only difference is the rod itself. Okay, so first up, let's just go ahead and mark the metal. And we'll call this one 6011. We'll call this one 6013. And we'll call this one 7018. Here's the little Lincoln welder. It's an AC 225 amp. And I've got it set on 105 amps. Not going to change that. Just going to change the rod. So let's fire it up. Get your helmet on, and we'll make some sparks. First up's going to be the 6011. You ready? Now let's try a little of that 6013. And let's try some of that 7018 and see what we get with that. Helmet off here. Let me chip the slag off real quick. So you can see the difference between the welds. This is the 6011. Not really pretty. It was actually a little over amperage, I think. You know, if I could have turned it down to like 100 amps or 95 amps, something like that. It'll kind of split the difference a little. The 6013, that's a nice looking weld. Lots of penetration. Came out nice and clean. Go back over here to 6011 for a second. You see all the burn? See how dusty it is, how dirty it is? There's lots of splatter around. For the 6013, nice and clean. Not a lot of splatter. The 7018, That looks even better. The difference between the three rods is the 6011 and the 6013 are eighth inch. The 7018 is next size up, 332nds, I think it is. A little bit bigger rod, so it can handle the higher amperage. Nice, clean looking weld. So you can find out all this information online. You can just Google, what welding rod do I use? And you can get lots of information there, so you can better pick the rod you want. That answers your question. See you next time.